This is part three of my dog eye series. I've already done the beagle eye and the Labrador Retriever eye, and I'm continuing with the poodle eye.
Hi, I'm Sara, and I make art.
Before we start though, I make videos to help you get better as an artist, so if you don't want to miss any of them, be sure to click the red subscribe button below this video, and click the bell to turn on notifications.
Starting by blocking in the background, for that I'm using a mix of brown and gray, with a little bit of yellow, because I want it to have a kind of golden tone, and a little bit of purple, because I don't want the yellow to be too bright. Going on this side now. Now the paint is dry, and I'm sketching on my eye with the charcoal pencil. I'm also mapping out where I'm going to have different shades in the fur. I'm starting to fill in the eye now with the dark brown. I'm using a small round brush to have something like a filbert brush, even though this is a large area, because the round brush gives me more control, and so I can keep the shape that I want, which is really important. Going through and refining that shape even more now. Now I've mixed more black into my brown, and I'm painting the, I don't even know what you call it, some fleshy thing that rims the eyeball. Anyway, I'm painting that now. I think I'm going to go over this later with a glaze of some more ivory black, but I'm just getting something down there for now. A little space on the edge that needs to be filled in. Now I'm glazing over that part with more of that ivory black that I was talking about. I'm refining the shape and also making it a little bit thicker. I'm going over this now with the transparent gray that I make by mixing transparent mixing white, or zinc white, and ivory black, because it didn't have the grayish cast that I wanted it to. I've already started to put these in the places according to where I see them in my reference photo and copy the shapes that I see. Also, you might notice my wrist moving back and forth kind of fast. That helps me get that texture too. There I go again, making those side-to-side motions. A round brush would probably be more practical for these things, but I was too lazy to switch brushes, so I was just using the side of my filbert brush. Now I'm using my liner brush and painting some hairs going out of the eye. Not because I want these lines to be super thin, per se, because I want them to have a certain shape, and like I've said before, the liner brush just gives me more control. And a couple more humps here. I'm going around the outer edge of his eye here with a very light gray, being careful to leave that black rim that I painted before untouched. Again, I'm refining my edges a bit more. Now I'm taking my liner brush and painting a blue spot that I made by mixing ultramarine blue with a little bit of titanium white. When you want something to be shiny, blue just takes it to the next level. And here I'm doing what I always do when I paint something shiny, which is I'm taking zinc white, which is in the Amsterdam line. The equivalent in the Liquitex Basics line would be transparent mixing white, and putting that where I think is appropriate. Now I'm starting in with my titanium white, but if I just got in with the titanium white to begin with, it would have just looked like white spots on the eye. Since I put it over the transparent mixing white, or zinc white actually, it looks like shine spots now. I went over that dark area I painted with a little highlight just to give it a bit more depth. And here's the finished eye.
I make art videos every week. You can find two more of them over here. And if you don't want to miss any, click here to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching.